In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make any logo 3D without plugins. Let's get to it. Here we are in After Effects. I'm going to begin by creating a new composition. You can see all of the settings over here. And the important one is the 3D renderer. Make sure you go into that and set renderer to be classic 3D and click OK. Then let's drag the logo to the timeline. I'll be using the Google Chrome PNG. Then press S on the keyboard and adjust the scale to your liking. I'm going to make it slightly smaller. Then I'm going to pre-compose the logo by right-clicking on it. Select pre-compose. You can call it logo and make sure you check move all attributes and click OK. Now we need to make this a 3D layer by checking this box. If you don't see this column, click toggle switches and modes until you do and check the 3D icon. Then after you've made the 3D layer, select it and press P on the keyboard to see the position property. Then right click on it and select separate dimensions. Then click away so you're not selecting anything. Then hold the Alt key on the keyboard and do a simple left click on the Z position stopwatch. Then inside of the text box, let's type index. Then click away, and now we're going to duplicate this layer a handful of times. That can be 30, 40 or more. The higher the count, the more extruded the logo will end up being. So I'm going to create 40 copies by selecting the logo composition and pressing Ctrl D. So here I have 40 copies of the logo layer, and since we've added the index expression for the Z position, every next logo that we duplicated was moved by 1 pixel on the Z axis. So if you look at this from the side, you can see that the logo is 3D, but it looks flat because we don't have any shadows, and we can create the fake shadow effect by using a simple trick. If we open effects and presets and search for curves, then add curve to the first layer so that we can see what's happening. And then inside of the effect controls panel, we're going to drag the top end of the graph down to the middle point. And that makes the logo darker. Now we're going to select the curves effect and press Ctrl X to cut and copy the effect. And then we're going to select the second layer from the top. Then scroll all the way down, hold shift and select the second layer from the bottom. Then press Ctrl V to paste the curves effect to those middle layers. Now, if you look at this from the side, you will see now that the middle layers are darker and the front and the back layers stay as they were. And that's how you create the fake shadow perspective. And after that, we can animate the logos by adding a null object. If you go up to layer, new null object, make sure you make it a 3D layer, also bring it to the top. Then let's select the first logo layer, then scroll all the way down and select the last logo layer by holding shift to select everything, scroll all the way up again, and we can either drag the parent pick whip onto the null or open the dropdown, and here select null 1, and that should parent all of the logo layers to the null. Now if you select the null 1, press R on the keyboard to see the rotation properties. Here I'm going to create a simple Y rotation animation. So if we go to the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for Y rotation at 0 degrees, then go to the end of the timeline and set the value to 359 degrees to create a perfect seamless loop. And if we give this a preview, here we have a rotating 3D logo, and this animation is completely procedural, so if at any point you need to change the logo, all you have to do is to open any of the logo compositions where the logo is, and then if you drag a different logo in here, make sure you match the size so it matches the previous logo size. Then hide or delete the previous logo that you had in here, then go back to the main composition. And if we give this a preview, here we have the exact same animation, but with a different logo. And this doesn't have to be logo. It can be text, it can be shape layers or anything of your choice. So thank you guys for watching.